Today is Brain Day. Hello, my name is Nunes. We will talk about some brain facts, neurological conditions, and what happens when our brain doesn't work normally. This is important for you. 60% of your brain is pure fat. That's right. It's the fattiest organ lounging around in your body. And those fats are like the unsung heroes of brain functionality. Think of healthy fats as the ultimate cell wall bodyguards, keeping everything stable, fighting off inflammation, and making sure your immune system is up and running efficiently. Dive deeper, and you'll find that about 75% of your brain is basically H2O. That makes a minor act of forgetting to hydrate. Even by just 2%, a major no-no for brain operations. Keep that water flowing. Your brain craves it more than you think. And here's a kicker. Your brain doesn't hit its full majestic form until you're 25. It's a slow roll from the back of your brain to the front, with your frontal lobes, the command center for planning and logic, being the last to fully connect. It's like your brain's own epic journey to maturity. The human brain has a weight of 3 pounds or 1.3 kilograms. Size, however, does not equate to intelligence. Males generally possess larger brains compared to females. Nonetheless, the brains of both genders are more similar than dissimilar. Think you're a multitasking master? Think again. Our brains are actually pulling a fast one on us. Instead of juggling tasks like an expert circus performer, we're just playing a speedy game of tag, hopping from one task to the next. So when you're trying to watch TV, answer emails, and snack all at once, your brain is really just doing a frantic dance between activities. The brain itself is incapable of sensing pain. This is because there are no pain receptors within the brain tissue. However, the meninges, the brain's coverings, periosteum, the bone's coverings, and the scalp all contain pain receptors. Thus, it is possible to perform surgery on the brain without the brain perceiving any pain. Your brain consumes 20% of the oxygen and blood in your body. It requires a steady flow of oxygen to function properly. The brain's visual sectors are situated at the rear. The occipital lobe, which is tasked with vision, resides in the back of the brain. Hence, a blow to the back of the head might cause you to see stars. Information in the brain can move at an astonishing speed of up to 268 miles per hour or 431 kilometers per hour. When activated, a neuron sends an electrical signal that hops from one cell to another. Any interruption in this flow can trigger an epileptic seizure. The spinal cord serves as the primary conduit for messages between the body and the brain. ALS, or amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, leads to the death of neurons in both the brain and spinal cord, affecting controlled muscle movements. Another condition impacting both the brain and spinal cord is multiple sclerosis, MS. In MS, the immune system attacks the myelin sheath covering nerve fibers, disrupting the communication between the brain and the body. Migraines stem from a chemical reaction, chemical activity in your brain, the nerves or blood vessels surrounding your skull, or the muscles of your head and neck, or some combination of these factors, can play a role in primary headaches. Serotonin, crucial for nerve cell communication, plays a role. Changes in serotonin or estrogen levels can trigger headaches or migraines for some. While serotonin impacts both genders, estrogen fluctuations are specific to women. For further insight into common neurological conditions, refer to the video linked in the description below. The brain is segmented into three primary areas. The cerebrum, which is the largest section, oversees voluntary actions, creativity, and thought processes. It acts as the brain's CEO, making all the critical decisions. The cerebellum is in charge of coordination and balance. Consider it the brain's choreographer, ensuring your movements are seamless and elegant. Lastly, the brainstem functions as the essential life support, controlling fundamental tasks like breathing, heart rate, and sleep cycles. It's the relentless worker operating out of sight to sustain your life. Let's explore how the connection between specific substances in the brain and neurological or psychological issues underscores the complex and delicate operations of our brain's functionality. Depression is often linked to imbalances in neurotransmitters such as serotonin, norepinephrine, and dopamine. These chemicals play key roles in regulating mood, emotions, and feelings of well-being. A deficiency in serotonin, for example, is commonly associated with feelings of sadness, lethargy, and a lack of interest in activities once enjoyed. Some treatments for depression aim to increase serotonin levels in the brain, thereby improving mood and emotional state. ADHD is characterized by symptoms such as inattention, hyperactivity, and impulsivity. It has been associated with an imbalance in dopamine and norepinephrine, neurotransmitters that are critical for attention and executive function. Dopamine plays a key role in reward and motivation pathways in the brain, affecting how individuals respond to stimuli. Medications like stimulants work by increasing the levels of these neurotransmitters, helping to improve concentration and reduce hyperactivity and impulsivity in individuals with ADHD. Anxiety disorders have been linked to an imbalance in neurotransmitters like serotonin and gamma-aminobutyric acid, GABA. GABA is an inhibitory neurotransmitter that helps regulate feelings of fear and anxiety. When GABA levels are too low, it can lead to an overactive nervous system, resulting in symptoms of anxiety. Similarly, as with depression, low levels of serotonin can also contribute to anxiety. Treatments often focus on restoring the balance of these neurotransmitters. While closely related to ADHD, attention deficit as a broader term can refer to difficulties in maintaining focus and attention due to various underlying causes. Neurotransmitter imbalances, particularly involving dopamine, can affect an individual's ability to concentrate on tasks, organize thoughts, and follow through on activities. Enhancing dopamine function is a common target for improving attentional capabilities. Our journey through the wonders of the brain is far from over. Thanks for tuning in. Don't forget to hit like, share this journey with friends, subscribe for more insights, and drop your thoughts in the comments below. Your engagement fuels our exploration.